Hello guys, now we are going to learn about free and open source software. What is free and open source software? So getting in detail with the free and open source software before, we should take few example of free and open source software. Let me give you a clear cut example of free and open source software, that is Android. Most of students or most of people uses Android phone. We are using Android phone. Few people uses Android phone of Samsung. Few people uses Android phone of Yamaha. Few are even Lenovo. Number of companies using Android phone. How it is possible? Simple cause behind it. Is Android is free and open source. So what is the free and what is the open source? Mostly open source softwares are free, but not all free softwares are open source. Let me give you a simple example. You have seen the Internet Explorer is a software browser which is free, but it is not open source. It's a licensed product of Microsoft. Let me give you another example. VLC player. VLC player is used as a video player in most of operating system. Even you can use it in Android also. So before going in detail, why Android is famous? It's because it's free and open source. That's why Android phones are cheap. It's really cheap. Starts from 4,000 and 5,000, but on other hand, let's see, what about Microsoft phones? There's even BlackBerry phones, even iPhones. iPhones are so much costly. Why? Because iPhones are not free. iPhones has macOS, which is iOS. macOS is for Microsoft. macOS is for Apple laptop, for iPad, etc., etc. But why Android is that much? Why Android phones are cheap? Because Android is free and open source. Actually, basically, I don't want to go in detail with the Android. You will see it afterwards. But here, Android is free and open source product of Google. Google provides, even you can develop a Android phone. You just need to gather all devices and you can easily take Android and you can release it with your phone. Free means you can get it of free of cost. Open source means it is right now for you guys to know the open source. It's quite difficult for you. Let me tell you what the software means first. What the software means first, then you can see what actually software means. I think if you have done MSc IT, you know what actually how software is developed. Software is nothing but thousands or lakh or million lines of codes written in various programming languages. I have told you in before lecture, more than 10,000 languages, programming languages are used, were used while programming. Then what comes next? So you need to write code to do something, or to write a program, you need to write a code. When you take a software, you don't get a code of that software. You just get a executable copy of that software. Let me give you a simple example. Dennis Ritchie and Ken Thompson, both are the scientists who develop. Dennis Ritchie developed a C language. C is the programming language. You will see it afterwards. C language who developed. Then they were working on developing the Unix, and that project with IBM. And something happened with that project, then they left that project. They have given that total coding with source code to MIT students, which are the engineering student in America. And then that operating system Unix becomes open source because source code is always with it. But what happened next? Then there comes the another deal with the IBM and Microsoft owner Bill Gates. Microsoft wanted to have an operating system for their computer. The deal is done, but what Bill Gates given to IBM, Bill Gates give just Bill Gates provided just executable copy of DOS to IBM. And whenever IBM computers comes up, IBM computer comes up with Bill Gates copy of DOS, disk operating system, which is the operating system before right now whatever you see Microsoft operating system. Before it was a black screen operating system, all text are there. That is the DOS operating system. So that is the case. So then what happened? All my IBM part got pirated, means lots of company got in computer business. They are developing the PCs which already developed by IBM. Similar kind of computer. Right now there are number of computer developing companies are there. So then they come with the Microsoft operating system, but pirated copy of IBM is there, but no one could able to pirate the Microsoft. Why? Because it is closed source operating system. So right now Microsoft is widely used, but you are having choices about taking the hardware. You can take any hardware from IBM also, IBM or hardware from Intel also, hardware from any. There are number of computer providing companies, even laptop you can see. But you can take operating system for, you just take operating system of Microsoft because it is seems that it is user friendly. But that is not case. There are other operating system are also there. Even you can see the Mac OS. Mac OS can only run on Mac computer, Apple computer. So let us see the free and open source. In this subject, we are just going to learn what is free and open source concept. There are number of things we should learn. What is free and open source software? I have said you what is free software means, which comes up with no cost. And what is open source means, that comes up with source code of means. If you are having a free and open source software, you can also make changes in that software to make personalized for you. So there are the features given here about free and open source software: security, affordability, transparent, interoperable on multiple platform, flexible due to customization, localization is possible. See here. You just saw, I think you have seen Microsoft operating system, Windows 10, Windows 7, Windows XP. I think you have seen. But there are other operating system, Linux, Mac OS. There are a number of operating system available. Even in Linux, there are 10 to 12 companies who provides various types of Linux to you. Okay, here in this subject we are just going to learn open source software, and in the practical part we are going to deal with open source. So let us see little bit about practical part. Have you seen Wikipedia? Wikipedia is free and open source kind of thing. Free and open source. You don't see any advertise on Wikipedia website. It's just free of cost. You don't have any advertise, and even you can contribute on Wikipedia. That is what I am going to teach you, how how to contribute on Wikipedia. When it's not a big deal to contribute on Wikipedia, there are basic things you should learn and you can easily contribute on Wikipedia. When you are going to learn what actually GitHub is, GitHub, if you are going to be a programmer, you should contribute as a programmer. Means on a GitHub is a free and open source software development community where you can add something. If you are having a something programming language, you can easily contribute there. See, here free and open source software, freeware, shareware, proprietary software. These are three different types of softwares. Shareware means you can share it anywhere. You don't need any kind of license. Freeware means available with free of cost. Means you can use and you can even distribute it with free of cost. Proprietary software, you can take a simple Microsoft software example. Okay, so that is the little bit introduction for free and open source software. We will stop here. Thank you. And please comment below. If comment is going to be your attendance, and if you are commenting any questions, I will answer in next video. It will be a good communication. Thank you. Bye bye.